The first value that we are looking at is blood hemoglobin level. 65 hemoglobin is lower than normal. Decreasing hemoglobin concentration we call anemia, and once we see anemia, we have to determine how severe is the anemia and which type of anemia is it according to the size of red blood cells. So, how severe is the anemia? In order to tell this, we have to know two values. It's 110 and 80. So normal hemoglobin level for male is 130-160. From 110 to lower limit of normal is mild anemia, from 80 to 110 is moderate anemia, and lower than 80 is severe anemia. So in this case, hemoglobin value is 65, so it's severe anemia. The type of anemia according to the size of red blood cells we determine by MCV. With MCV we have to know two values, it's 100 and 80. The red blood cells with MCV between 80 and 100 we call normocytes, greater than 100 macrocytes, and lesser than 80 microcytes. In this case, MCV is 62.8, so it's microcytes. Thereby, it's severe microcytic anemia. Usually, when hemoglobin is low, red blood cells are low. And in this case, red blood cells 3.9, which is lower than normal. The next value is platelets. Platelets are 475, which is a little bit higher than normal. The next value are white blood cells. As we see, white blood cell count is 9, which is normal. White blood cells is a collective term. We include into white blood cells several type of cells. So now we have to see, maybe some cells that we include into white blood cells are elevated. And there are three major possibilities. White blood cells consist of three major groups of cells. It's blood cells, lymphocytes, and myelocytes. The first cells that we are looking at are blasts, because in normal state there are no blast cells in peripheral blood. And here blast cells are zero, so it's perfectly normal. The next cells are lymphocytes. Lymphocytes are 23%, which is also normal. Myelocytes consist of neutrophils, basophils, eosinophils, and monocytes. First of all, we are looking at neutrophils. Segmented forms are normal, bands normal, metamyelocytes normal, and myelocytes normal. So all forms of neutrophils are perfectly normal. After neutrophils, we are looking at basophils, which are normal. Eosinophils are normal, and monocytes are also normal. Erythrocyte sedimentation rate is also within normal range. So it's severe microcytic anemia accompanied by slight increase in platelets. Now we have to determine the type of microcytic anemia, and there are four possibilities. Microcytic anemia can be caused by iron deficiency, it can be anemia of chronic disease, sideroblastic anemia, and thalassemia. Two most common anemias are iron deficiency anemia and anemia of chronic disease. In order to exclude these two anemias, we have to determine the level of ferritin. Ferritin in case of iron deficiency should be low, and in case of anemia of chronic disease, ferritin should be elevated. In this case, ferritin level is very low, so it's iron deficiency anemia. Usually, together with ferritin, we determine the level of transferrin and serum iron. The reason is that iron deficiency anemia is the most common microcytic anemia. So every time when we see microcytic anemia, our first thought is iron deficiency. And to determine how profound is iron depletion, we also determine transferrin and serum iron. The first value that decreases in iron deficiency is ferritin. The second step is increase in transferrin, and the third step is decrease in serum iron. So in this case, ferritin is very low, transferrin is high, but serum iron is still normal. So at this moment, it's not total iron depletion. But very soon without treatment, serum iron will be also lower than normal. Once we determine iron deficiency anemia, the next step is to determine the cause. Usually it's chronic bleeding or some cancer. And treatment usually is iron pills with 2+ iron, because this form is more easily absorbed in the duodenum.